My next experience was another kind of tea date. So this guy, I actually matched with him on Tinder. I was really trying to make the effort to go out more. But anyways, we matched and we exchanged numbers pretty quickly. And we were talking like on WhatsApp, kind of texting back and forth. Not so much, just like, when would you like to meet up for a drink? All right, good. I didn't actually have a phone call with this guy. Yeah, we texted a little bit back and forth. Arranged a date to meet. He tried to meet somewhere in the middle. For some reason, he wanted to meet at the train station and then find somewhere to get a coffee. We ended up going to a pub. It was horrible weather that day. It was really, really horrible weather. It was raining. I don't really like meeting people at the station and then walking to wherever, unless I'm the one on the train and they're just there to meet me at the platform. That I find that actually a bit romantic, when somebody's just like waiting for you at the train platform, you know, with a bunch of flowers. No, I'm just kidding. But I don't really like hanging out at the front of a train station when it's busy and it's rush hour and people are back and forth. I prefer to just meet you at one particular location. And to be honest, the next time I meet anyone, I'm gonna make sure they suggest a place. But actually, the next guy suggested a place, but that's another story which I'll get onto. Eventually, he made it to the station. The first thing he did was give me a kiss on the cheek, and I was just like, why? I don't really know you. What do you guys think? A guy that you've literally just swapped a few texts with and he's kissing you on the cheek to say hello. A hug, I don't mind. A handshake, a bit formal, but I don't mind it either. But like, I think a kiss is a bit too much. People always usually kiss, like, they're kissing the air and they're tapping cheeks. They're not literally kissing you on the cheek. Unless they actually love you, that was not really necessary. He was an older man. So the first guy, Ben, he was the same age as me. He was 29. I was 29 as well. And this guy, the second guy, I think he was 37. What can we call him? Let's call him Tom. So Tom, he told me he was a teacher, primary school teacher. When we started the date, I immediately knew that this was not the man for me. I never asked him his height because I was just like, no, I'm just not going to judge people for their height and stuff. Like, I'm sure he's tall enough, but I really do care about height. I just went on the date. He was quite a small guy. Yeah, he seemed quite sad. He seemed quite like depressed a bit, quite down. And so, do you know, I just said to myself, I'm just gonna try and make a bad situation good. I was just being talkative. I was just like trying to have a good time. Like, you know, you never know. I was just trying to have a good time. I was just treating him like a human being. I was not like acting disappointed. Why are you frowning? Or I just thought, I'm just gonna be happy and I'm just gonna like brighten this like situation. So that's what I did, and eventually he started laughing, he started talking, but I had to put that work in to bring him out of himself. I don't know if he's had a bad day or whatever, but I just tried to make the situation good. After that, he never planned anything for the future. He never said, oh yeah, it'd be nice to meet up again. And I never suggested anything because I really was not interested, and I knew that from the very first moment. So then we said goodbye again with the kiss, and I never communicated with him. I don't think he communicated with me. Eventually, I just ended up deleting his phone number, deleting the chat. I just removed it from my phone and I just moved on. So that was the second date with Tom. So there's been Ben, there's been Tom, and then finally there's Greg. So Greg, I met on Tinder again. Again, I was not looking so much at like looks or anything like that. I was like swiping right and left, and eventually we matched. I think he was wearing his doctor uniform in his profile picture. I don't think that's what caught my attention, but then, you know, when somebody's a doctor, it's almost like, oh wow, this is like an intelligent man, this is like an established man. Even if you're not a shallow person, which I'm not a shallow person, it kind of makes you think like, ooh, a doctor. But I'm not really like that. I don't feel like I have to marry a doctor or a lawyer or something like that. I wasn't really attracted to his profile picture or anything like that, or his appearance. Oh yeah, the first guy was Croatian, the second guy was English, he was an English man, and the third guy was also an English man, but from the north. So he was a northerner. As soon as we matched, he was texting me. He also said something like, it'd be nice to have a phone call sometime. So we arranged to have a phone call, but then what he did was he actually tried to video call me, and I was just like, I am not ready for a video call. So I just cancelled. When somebody just calls you and you're not ready for a video call, like, would you just take it and then just point the camera to the ceiling or somewhere? So I was like, no, you want a video call, you need to make an appointment. I just didn't feel comfortable with it, but I was comfortable with a phone call. So the English guy called me, like, he was telling me, yeah, I'm from North, I'm from Manchester, blah blah blah. He was telling me all his about his passions and stuff. He does like environment work and stuff, and I was like, oh, okay, cool. We're just having a general conversation. I felt like the conversation was really flowing quite naturally. It was actually quite normal. It was actually quite nice. And I've not been on many dates with like English guys, but obviously I grew up in England, they grew up in England. Yeah, I'm African, but I feel like we have more in common than I thought. Then after the conversation ended, he says, oh well, I'm gonna send you a text to invite you out properly. Then as soon as we put the phone down, he was asking me if I would like to go to one of these jazz clubs in London, in Soho. And I was like, yeah, definitely. We arranged to meet outside the jazz club in Soho. It's actually this jazz club called Ronnie Scott's, and to be honest, I've been wanting to go there for ages. I've just never been. After the phone call, I texted him to ask him, hi, I don't really mean to be shallow, but how tall are you? He took a few moments to think about it and he texts me, I'm 5'10". It's okay, you're not being shallow. Something like, all that matters is attraction, or all that matters is that we are attracted to each other, right? And I was like, yeah, all that matters is that we're attracted to each other. I think for me, like, the height is part of the attraction. Not because I feel like tall men are the most attractive men in the world. It's not really that, it's because I'm tall. I'm 5'7" and it just feels good to me to be with somebody who's a bit taller. It just feels good to me. Obviously, if I was like 4'11" or 5', and I was dating a man who was like 5'7", 5'8", I'd be like, you know, I'd be swooning. We met at the jazz club and I could see him from a distance, and I could tell that this guy, he lied about his height. So ever since I've come back to London, I've been dating short men. Not only short, but short and also small. I mean, you can see me. I've got some meat on me, I've got some muscles, I've got some, you know, flesh on me. So anyway, that's beside the point. That's beside the point. Like I said, the more you guys keep lying about your height, the higher a woman's height restrictions or height requirements becomes. Because then I'm thinking, wait a minute, I thought 5'10" is meant to be taller than me. Okay, then I think I'll go for 6'2". I think 6'2" is okay for me then. And really, 5'10" is perfectly fine, but it's just that you're not 5'10". I got there and I didn't see him there. And so I was like, you know, where are you? I'm here. I finally arrived. And he was like, oh, I went for a walk around the block to stretch my legs. And I was like, Rick, I was like, why would anybody do that when you know you have to be here at 7 o'clock and you went for a walk around the block to stretch your legs? Just admit it and just say you're late. It's okay to be like 5-10 minutes late. Like, I'm not gonna bite your head off, you know? I'm not gonna attack you for being a bit late. But don't lie and say you went for a walk around the block when you're just, you know, 10 minutes late. I was late myself. I was like, what, 7 minutes late? We realized it was actually free entry before 8 o'clock. We entered the jazz club and we ordered some wine. I made a mistake of not eating before I came out, because I was thinking, well, maybe we're gonna eat there, maybe not. They do serve food, but we just ordered wine and I wasn't thinking about really buying myself food. Anyway, now I know. Now I actually know it's better to just come out and ask, like, are we going out for dinner or are we going out for just drinks? It's just good to kind of talk about these things and just ask the question. Don't feel as if you're being too much by asking a simple question like, are we going for food or is it drinks, whatever. I've never been to that jazz club before, Ronnie Scott's, but I do know that they serve food. So it was Ronnie Scott's upstairs. It was not really awkward. It was just talking and the conversation just kept going. Obviously, when he was sitting next to me, I did feel as if, oh, I'm sitting next to this guy, is quite small, but I just thought, no, I'm just gonna have a good time. Like, it doesn't matter. I'm not gonna judge him because of that. We can still have a nice date as just two individuals on a date. So I just really tried to make the most of it. The wine was actually helping me just like kind of loosen up and just like talk more and just have a good time, enjoy the music. Actually, the music hadn't started playing yet. The music started playing around 9 or 9:30. And so we all moved forward. Everybody was like dancing, everybody had a drink in hand, everybody was just grooving. And we were both dancing, him and I, obviously not together and not face to face, but like side by side. We're just enjoying the music, and honestly, I was just really, really loving it. It's been a while since I've been out to a jazz band. I didn't really feel the attraction because there was no attraction. But you know, when you give somebody a chance, I feel like there's always that opportunity for attraction to grow. I went to the bathroom and then I came back, and I remember I was next to the keyboardist guy, and it was like in the corner. He was like, oh, are you trying to go in the corner? I was like, you know, in that Manchester accent, I was like, oh, he was just annoyed because, like, I'm not trying to go in the corner. I'm literally, this is my space. Like, I'm just in my space. I'm not trying to go in a specific, in a squeeze in the corner. Like, this is my space. I'm standing right next to you. I'm in the space. I'm not trying to go in a corner. Anyway, that kind of annoyed me a little bit. You can see this place is cramped. I'm not trying to go in a corner. It's cramped. Then we decided to leave. Well, I decided to leave. And he was like, yeah, well, we can both leave. I think it was around 11:30 or midnight. But thing is, the music started so late. So we left around 11. I decided, okay, it's time for me to go. But I really did not want to leave. The music was so good. But I knew I had to wake up early the next morning. So then I said to him, okay, it's really nice to meet you. I had a really nice time. And yeah, and he was, oh no, but I'll walk you to the station. He was like, I can go to any station. So we both walked to the station, the tube station, so that I could get a tube back to the train station. He could get any tube because he was living on a tube line. He was taking the tube in the opposite direction. You know, like in the movies when people are saying goodbye to each other and they're like, okay, well, yeah, it was nice to meet you. It's like mentally puckering up for, like, I don't know, a kiss or I don't know what, saying, oh, come back to me. No, I'm not coming back to anybody's. Like, no, there was no attraction there. We really just had a good evening listening to music. That was it. I was like, okay, well, bye. And we just said goodbye. Then I just went home. I went home knowing that actually, yeah, I had a really nice time listening to this music, but this guy is not the one for me. He actually texted me the next day saying it was a fun date, but I don't think we are similar. That was so weird. Similar in what way? Because as far as I was concerned, the conversation was flowing. It was not really awkward. I could have really made it awkward by saying, you're not 5'10", but I didn't say that. I was just like, no, forget it. Like, you know, it's not all about height, but I did feel so big. I felt like I was a giant compared to him, but I wasn't a giant. We were the same height, or like maybe he's a little bit shorter than me. I did feel like a bit of a big person. And usually I do like to feel not necessarily smaller, but I do like to feel like more of the feminine person. I do like to feel like I'm with really like a masculine guy. Just replied to him, yeah, it was really fun. Thank you so much for sending me this text. I totally 100% agree, and I wish you all the best for 2020. Goodbye. And that was it, really. I really liked the fact that he texted me to kind of clean cut the situation off. That dating experience really taught me a lesson that actually you should give short men a chance as well. Don't immediately rule out a guy just because he's a small guy, he's a short guy. Because if you had met that guy face to face, like at university or out and about or in some friend circle, just somewhere, you might not be judging him for his height. Obviously, if he's much shorter than you, then it's easier to notice. But if you meet him face to face and he just happens to be 5'8" and you're 5'7", you're not exactly going to be thinking, oh my goodness, you're too short for me. Most of the time, when you see it like written on a dating profile or on paper, it's like, it's too short for me. So it really taught me that actually, if I were to meet somebody face to face and he happened to be like 5'8" or 5'9", 5'10", then I could actually give it a go. Like, I don't have to, like, 6 foot doesn't have to be like the minimum. It's almost like 6 foot doesn't mean anything anymore because of all the lying that men are doing about their height. But again, these dating experiences taught me that actually it's not so bad to date a guy who's just a few inches taller than you or even the same height. Like, it is possible. Like, I know people do fall in love regardless of height. A man can be shorter and you can still fall in love with him. I guess that's the lesson, really. I was actually talking to a friend about this and she told me that I shouldn't really worry about that lie, even though usually lying is definitely frowned upon. But she said I shouldn't really worry about the height lie because a lot of short men have been forced to lie about their height, because if they say their real height, women just don't give them a chance at all because they immediately think like they are too small. And so, yeah, she was saying that actually she kind of understands the fact that somebody would have to lie about their height. But what do you guys think? Is it acceptable for men to lie about their height to get dates? And if you went on a date with a guy who had lied about his height and you happened to like him, would you stay with him regardless of his lies? Or would you be like, nope, you've lied about this, God knows what you'll be lying about next? Would you think he's a liar, or would you think he's just trying to make it in this world? Would you think it was just a case of, you know, survival of the fittest? This video has gone on for long enough. I hope you have enjoyed it. Unfortunately, it was a really unsuccessful dating experience, but I guess I kind of learned my lesson, and each meeting, each encounter, each date, I get to learn a little bit more about myself, about men, about how, you know, how dating works, about how to do things better next time. Let me know if you've enjoyed me sharing this story. Unfortunately, there's no tea to spill. So yeah, give this video a thumbs up if you've enjoyed it. Please subscribe if you're not already subscribed, as well as turn your notifications on so you know exactly when I've uploaded the video. And please do head over to follow me on Instagram, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.